It is the Cycling Road Women's Individual Time Trial at Rio 2016. Also back for an attempt at another medal is the 2012 bronze medalist, Russia's Olga Zabalinskaya. Only eight nations have won medals in the women's time trial. Today, the race of truth will be a true test of the abilities of the 25 riders from 19 nations that make up this field. Starting around 40Ks from Copacabana Beach, the 29.7-kilometer lap of the Grumari circuit. It's the same one that was used during the road race. And they will not be riding the cobbles, but they will be climbing the Grumari ascent, 1.3 kilometers. The tricky descent, tough in the dry, will be even more difficult in the wet. A long drag towards the Grotta Fondo climb, 2.1 kilometers, an average gradient of 6.8 kilometers. A wider but fast descent, again treacherous in the wet potentially. And then from the bottom, it's 8 kilometers to the finish for the women's time trial. 29.7 kilometers, 25 riders, 19 nations. Anna Fichter has the honor of the pole of leading out the field. The 20-year-old Lotte Kopecky, who enjoyed a 65-kilometer period on her own up front in the road race. And we get down to Emma Pooley, who's returned to the sport, silver medalist in 2008. And then we get into the business end of the competition. Kristen Armstrong looking for an unprecedented hat-trick of medals here. The world champion Linda Willemsen and the road race champion Anna van der Breggen finish it off the last three to ride. Sitting alongside me once more, it's a pleasure to welcome Rochelle Gilmore. Rochelle, it is tough conditions for the riders out there today.
It certainly is. I mean, we've got the worst conditions that the riders could have hoped for today. So that's an additional challenge to an already very challenging circuit. And it's just a really hard race to pick today. There's so many favourites and the riders that are on form now. We're looking at the Australian, Katrin Garfoot. Not a perfect preparation for her. She's had a troubled last month with illnesses. But as the coach says, she'll give it her best shot today.
Our first rider to leave the start ramp is Anna Pichter, the 24-year-old Pole. They will leave at 90-second intervals, the 25 riders. Leaving the start out at any time is a tense time, but to be first rider off.
She rode the road race.
Rio 2016 is underway, and 24-year-old Pole Anna Pichter is the first to head out on the 29.7-kilometer course around the Grumari circuit. Two particular climbs, no cobbles, as they had to deal with on the road race that has been tarred. They will ride a tarred section there, but conditions very, very tricky indeed in the wet.
You can see already how much caution was taken coming off the ramp. Obviously, they don't know how many times have they had an opportunity to practice off that ramp. Some riders may not have even had the opportunity to ride down the ramp, not knowing how slippery it is. So there's a lot of caution being taken. And you can see Anna Pichter now as she goes down that ramp. Not too much power going through the pedals, just rolling off the ramp in case it's a little bit slippery. And we saw in that first corner how much caution is being taken.
Well, it will be wet. It's been raining most of the evening, most of the early morning. And so Pichter is the first to set out on this route. She was 41st in the road race at the Olympic Games a couple of days ago. The women not getting a huge amount of time to recover. Second off the start ramp, the young Belgian. She was inspirational in that road race, Lotte Kopecky. 20 years of age. One of two Belgians in the field, Lotte Kopecky, the 20-year-old, heads off as the second rider, 90 seconds behind Anna Pichter.
I think Kopecky's going to have a good ride today, just for herself, for experience here at the Olympic Games, because the road race that she had, she was out there in the breakaway. Very, very impressive ride. showed her strength. She's not a climber, she's a sprinter. She comes from a track background. See, also so much caution being taken in that first corner. But she'll be on a high. Belgium team's done extremely well so far in the road events, and the road race was just a really good demonstration of her strength and development at such a young age.
She headed out once they hit the Long Ocean Road and spent 65 Ks on a lone breakaway. She was only caught in the second lap of the Grumari loop, so a really great experience for Lotte Kopecky. Second at the 2016 Belgian National Championships, and so that's in the time trial. Second in the road race for the last 3 years as well. That's for the Lotte Soudal ladies team. And it's a gold medalist in the points at Omnium at the 2016 Junior European Championships. 29-year-old Christine Majerus from Luxembourg, 18th in the road race. She's 90 seconds later off the start rank. Despite the weather, good crowd out to send the riders on their way. Well, this last week, there's been no rain like this at all, so the riders wouldn't have had a chance to ride any of the course in these sort of conditions.
There certainly would have been a lot of discussion this morning about equipment, you know, last-minute changes to the width of the tyres and the tyre pressures. And it's very challenging for the time trial riders, too, that don't ride their time trial bikes very often, because they are obviously a different machine to their road bikes, and the positioning of the brakes and the integrated brakes for aerodynamics means that they're not as strong as road brakes. So it's a completely different feeling. And there'll have to be a lot of caution taken on the corners and the descents, simply due to that fact that they won't have had a lot of experience riding this course with their time trial bikes, these brakes in these conditions.
Christine Majerus, she won stages at the Women's Tour last year and this year, although did have a crash this year, also withdrew from the Giro Rosa. After a crash, she rides for that very powerful Bulls Dolmans team. And, this is Lotte Kopecky, still on the beachfront. And yes, we're going to get a lot of images like this on a rainy day like today. From Japan, the only Japanese rider in the field, 25-year-old Eri Yonamine, 17th in the road race here. You don't want to get it wrong on the start ramp, but she's off and safe and sound. It's Eri Yonamine from Japan.
Well, it was really fantastic to see that it was so hard to fight for this spot at the Olympics between two Japanese riders. Mari getting the all clear after winning the road race and the time trial at the national championships. However, there was another strong rider from Japan pushing for selection all the way. So it's great to see the development of the female Japanese cyclists.
Meanwhile, our first rider, Anna Pichter, on the first little rise into the Grumari circuit. This isn't the first of the really steep climbs. That will come in a little while.
Well, impressively, Pichter has finished 20th at Flèche Wallonne, so she, at the end of a hard race, being able to get up a climb like that says that she should be able to handle these climbs. Not a real specialist time trialer, but Norwegian rider on the start line. A little bit nervous getting up.
Pretty exposed. It's called the Race of Truth, the time trial. For good reason. Vita Heine. Been born and spent a year in Norway at the age of 18 and met her future husband there. So moved there in 2004 and became a Norwegian citizen in 2014. In fact, went to the 2013 World Championships for Latvia. She was runner-up in their time trial championships in 2011, 13 and 14. 33rd in the road race on Sunday.
She has some experience with team time trialing, having represented her professional team in the past in the team time trial. But only coming into the sport at 25 years of age, time trial specialists can do that, but it's not her specialty. I think she'll be She'll post a good time out there early off, but this is Lotta Kopecky we're back with now. We said it in the road race when she was in a long solo break that she does have a very nice riding style. And we were waiting for her to hit the wall being out there so long and being so young and from a track background, but she just consistently kept good pedal revolution. And as we said, she'll have really good spirits today, being on a bit of a height.
She left it all out there. It was wonderful to see. Well, not all, because she's got plenty in today. Lotta Lepisto from Finland, bottle tucked in to her skin suit. And away rolls Lotta Lepisto, our sixth rider in the women's time trial. 26-year-old Finn with plenty of talent. She didn't finish the road race on Sunday. 32nd of the world champs last year, 28th in 2014. National champion for the last 3 years for Finland. Very cautious again around that corner. Just it's a paved corner as well, so it makes it all the more tricky. With Lotta Kopecky. Yeah, beautiful style of the tracks rider. She's got to stay clear of those painted yellow lines. A lot of this road has been resurfaced as Plichter out of the saddle briefly on the climb.
Well, the challenging aspects of these this course, in particular having such steep sections and fast sections, they've had to have carefully chosen front chain rings, and a lot of the women have actually had to change their rear derailleurs to be longer to adjust for their gears. So there's been a lot of just the challenging aspect of having so many different things in the one course with these really steep climbs and fast sections.
It's been very, very dynamic. Audrey Cordon, the 26-year-old Frenchwoman, concern on her face as she's heading off here.
Well, certainly not the confident, relaxed face that we normally see of Audrey Cordon. Unfortunately, she's woken up very sick this morning. Tough decision whether to start the Olympic time trial. She had a great road race out there in the breakaway solo. Hit really, really good form for the Olympic Games, prepared specifically for it at altitude with the French national team. But that's how things go. Sometimes you put so much energy the last 12 months, particularly this woman, into preparation. She's a French national time trial champion of the last 2 years. And she would have loved to have a fantastic ride here, but you can see the stress and concern on her face of having woken up ill on the day of the Olympic time trial.
Very, very difficult situation. Do you ride, don't you ride? You might not get another chance. Who knows what will happen as Lotta Kopecky is up that reasonable incline. Now we move on to Tara Whitten, a very experienced Canadian rider, 36-year-old. Come back to the sport in 2014. She rides for Cyclery Opus Racing. Very different expression on her face.
Certainly very focused. This is the first of the real time trial specialists that we've seen on the start line.
13th in the World Championships last year, 4th in 2011, and the silver medalist in the Pan American Championships in 2015 as well.
We go back to 2010, she's won a Commonwealth Games in the individual time trial also. She has a lot of success on the track.
And of course the Canadian champion, Tara Whitten. Yeah, she's certainly one to be reckoned with. Originally a skier, so many of the North American athletes quite often are, as Christine Majerus is onto that similar section of the climb.
Well, she's had some impressive results this year while riding for the strongest team in the world, Bowles Dolmans. We'll see some riders later for Ellen van Dijk that rides for Bowles Dolmans. She's labelled as a domestique, which is employed to just work for the team, but she's had some opportunities this year and really taken them, winning a stage of the Aviva Women's Tour. It was a massive result for Christine Majerus. Not specifically a time, she's won the Luxembourg Time Trial Championship many, many times, but on world level, she's known more as a domestique and a sprinter.
She won the stage into Norwich on that women's tour. In fact, I think it was the first stage. So we go to Tara Witten. Now our second of the Polish riders, and this is another hugely talented young rider.
Absolutely, massive talent of the future. It's possibly our future Giro d'Italia winner, Kasia Nieuwendomma from Poland. Hasn't really been on top form the last month. She had a troubled stage, one of the key stages of the Giro d'Italia, when everybody was questioning her health or injuries. The road race, we didn't see her best climbing, but she certainly is a huge talent. Just saw a little slip of the front wheel there. You can see how slippery it is. So important to get the tyre pressures right for a race like this.
Nieuwendomma, sixth in the road race, and she's of course the Polish road race and time trial national champion. And, two stages and the GCN mountain classification, the Giro del Trentino this year.
She rides for the team of Marianne Vos, so she's been learning from the best. Tara Witten, Canadian.
In 2011 Omnium world champion on the track and also points race champion.
You see with the Japanese rider, she's one of very few. We haven't seen another rider so far that's not carried a bottle on the bike. As we say that, here's another one, Elena Amalusik.
27-year-old, 13th in the road race on Sunday. Championships last year, so away goes Amalusik from Belarus. Look at the wind you can see from the palm trees there. So cautious around that first corner, and later on in the course it's going to get very interesting. The descent off the Grimari climb is a very technical descent, so riders will be tensely aware of that, bearing in mind what has gone before on the roads of Rio during the road race.
You can just see the different expressions on these riders' faces, and the younger ones, they're just out there to tackle it, and the ones that are more experienced, they've got a more relaxed, composed face. They've been through the drill of this so many times. The energy of the young riders, they've just got no fear, just get out there and attack it.
Like this is the more experienced rider, Tara Witten.
Absolutely, Tara Witten would have been through the process of this time trialing. Now we see Emma Pooley, a little bit of stress on the start line there. She's not happy about the hold. So the swaying of the bike there to get the bike dead straight. That's a nervous face that we've seen there. A bit of a slip of the gears. Problems right from the start for Emma Pooley. Great Britain's big hope for a medal here in the women's road cycling events.
2008 silver medalist at the Olympic Games. She rode the road race in service of Lizzie Armistead, but did quite a bit of work there. Came back to the sport with the intention of racing at the Games for this particular race.
Well, that's a very tense start for Emma Pooley there. She wasn't happy with that position that she was being held in, and then a slip of the gears on the ramp. She's using the electronic gears. Just stops pedaling for a second there again, trying to get the gear in place.
Emma was sixth at the time trial in London in 2012. Was world time trial champion back in 2010. Now on to a sector that these riders will remember well. Every single one of these riders had to be entered for the road race, but fortunately today in these conditions, not having to ride the cobble section on the left, especially tarred section running along the right, there's the Japanese rider goes through that. So to Carol Ann Canule, 25th in the road race on Sunday, the 28-year-old Canadian, sixth at the 2014 World Championships. Second of the Canadians off the start ramp, Caroline Canuel.
This is a rider that's a very, very quiet achiever. She rides in the shadows of her superstar teammates at Bowles Dolmans, but she is the backbone of the team. She's a very strong domestique. We can see now your Olympic road race champion, Anna van der Breggen. She's got that bump in the back of her skin suit. Looks like a radio.
Well, Emma Pooley here, the 2010 world champion, after that tricky start. I mean, the wind was, you could see as she was on that start, the wind was whistling through. They're very exposed there. And amongst the lighter riders in this field, Emma Pooley.
Well, I've watched Emma Pooley compete at many, many championships. This rider is also struggling to get her bike straight. That's just the play of the wind. Difficult for the holders to hold the riders dead straight. You can see the concentration on the man behind her just trying to keep that bike dead straight.
Sofiane Dirk from Belgium, the 28-year-old. To finish the road race, ninth in the time trial at the World Championships last year in Richmond. Top 10 in 2014, fifth. In fact, every single one of the top 10 last year are in this field from the World Championships last year. Yeah, the riders showing incredible concentration and focus, just keeping steady on the start ramp, the wind and the wet.
That was one of the most aggressive starts we've seen off the ramp so far. A lot of power going through the pedals. An outside chance for a medal, but most likely to be around normally fourth to, you know, eighth place. But Sofiane Dirk, she's a name that everybody refers to as a TT specialist. She'll be out there today to post a good time for Belgium.
Second in GC in the Tour de Bretagne, and third in the time trial there. And won the time trial at the Gracie Orlova race. So this is flicked up. Look how cautiously around these twisting turns. She's come up the first ascent of the Grumari climb, and now the first down that twisting, nervous descent. Now, this is Vita Heine, powerful rider from Norway, the former Latvian. Doesn't look as though it's quite as bad on this sector of the road where they had all those difficulties on the cobbles. Trixie Warwick, serious contender?
Serious contender. Just started her time there. She wants to get the file. That's an important part of an athlete's preparation for big events, and she'll certainly want to have a power file from today. But this is one of your most experienced time trial riders that you'll see. Trixie Warwick, she had a very troubled year with a very bad accident early in the season. She lost a kidney sliding under a guardrail. Could have been the end of her career. Came back to win the national time trial championship for Germany, which is not an easy task. So she came back strong, and you can see just in the front of her skin suit there, we might get another look at that, but she had a bottle of liquid just put down the front of her skin suit for later.
So Lotte Kopecky is our second rider on the road at the moment. And over the top of that first climb, she's coming into the timing marker. And she's a little down on Anna Pichter. Oh, very careful. Foot off as she went down there.
It's so difficult because when they go up these climbs that are so steep, they go into the red and they lose focus of what's coming up over the top. And you could see she carried a little bit too much speed, but saved herself there with clipping out the foot.
So very cautious on that descent.
So first time check at 9.6 kilometers. She's 22 seconds behind Plichter. Now we see your Australian Katrin Garfoot.
An aggressive start from her as well. Didn't finish the road race, fourth in the World Championships last year, so certainly with some hope for the Australians, Katrin Garfoot.
Well, since that fourth place at the World Championships last year, Australia has put a lot of effort into preparing this rider specifically for the time trial at the Olympic Games. But as we said before, she has had a troubled last 1 month. She had a perfect altitude training block, and then she came down and she got sick, and it was so difficult to manage. How hard do you push? and just so many missed sessions and interrupted sessions, but she'll give it her best shot today.
Christine Measure is approaching the first of those timing mats at 9.6 kilometers up the climb. Looking down and some concern here. And she's 26 seconds down. You should hold your breath as they come down this first corner.
It's a really tricky section over the top because they're in their small chain ring and they need to get into their big chain ring. And as we've discussed earlier, there's a big difference between the number of teeth on the small one and the big one. So it's a long way that the chain needs to travel from the small ring up to the big ring. And you can see over the top of the climb, they want to get into the big ring, but it's a little bit of struggle for these chains to get from the small chain ring up to the big chain ring.
And we just saw evidence there of Audrey Cordon's difficulties. She's already been caught by Tara Whitten on that section next to the cobbles. Tara Whitten acknowledged as one of the stronger time trialists, but as Rochelle was saying, Audrey Cordon woke up this morning not feeling good, and you don't get caught that quickly.
That would be
there's a problem there.
Yeah, devastating for Audrey Cordon, the French national time trial champion, coming into the Olympic Games and falling ill on the morning of the time trial, but that's all indications now. She's been caught. This is a picture of Audrey Cordon here, your French national champion. Tara Whitten, time trial specialist, has just passed her.
This is on the flat section just after the cobbles, and Tara Whitten will hit the climb first. The 1.3-kilometre ascent of the Grumari, and it gets really, really steep at times. Sometimes some of the sections up to 16%.
Elisa Longo-Borghini, the Italian, outside chance for a medal.
Appears that Elisa is starting. We haven't seen the start of Ashley Moorman-Passio of South Africa. No news of her. Now a really aggressive start here from Elisa Longo-Borghini.
Well, the spirits of this rider will certainly be high after a successful road race at the Olympic Games, a bronze medal for the Italians. And Elisa Longo-Borghini, this course is everything that she would have hoped for. She won't be too intimidated by the wet. She's a fantastic bike handler. You can see she got around that corner so much faster than the earlier riders that we saw. She's on a mission. Pressure's off now that she already has a medal from the Olympic Games. We're back with Tara Whitten, who we saw pass Audrey Cordon just before. That would have given her a load of confidence. And she looks super fit. Obviously a very specific preparation for the Olympic Games time trial. She won the Canadian time trial coming back from injury.
Up the saddle and up that climb, Tara Whitten really, really aggressive and focused on producing. Look at the wind again, whistling around there.
Helen van Dijk, one of your favorites for a medal today. Kristen Armstrong, two times Olympic Games gold time trial medalist.
This is Ghana Solovey. Meanwhile, the fastest time of that first time check was the Japanese rider. You know what I mean? And she is around 8.27 seconds ahead of Anna Pichter. Lotte Kopecky, only half a minute back, 27.90. 36th in the road race for the 24-year-old Ukrainian. Like all of them, just negotiating that first corner cautiously. Second at the Ukrainian National Championships. This is Emma Pooley of Great Britain. Closing in, the latest news is that Lotta Lepisto has moved into second place, just 2.36 seconds behind the Japanese rider. Yonamin. So at the moment it's Yonamin, Lepisto in first and second place. Becky in third.
We're now looking at Emma Pooley. Back to Ellen van Dijk. What a sensational road race at the Olympic Games she had in function of her teammate who won. Super domestique, time trial specialist, climbing at the best of her ability in this particular week.
Oh, there's a lot of tension out there, isn't there, Rochelle? Amazing, the tension on the faces of these riders, and with good reason. She's such a powerful rider. She's got to be careful not to overdo it down there start ramp. But away she goes. Ellen van Dijk, one of the finest time trialists around, but does this course suit her?
The hills will add an additional challenge. It's not really got Ellen van Dijk's name all over it, but her form has. She's got extremely good form at the moment. And that was a powerful start. She means business today. You can see, interestingly, one of the first riders we've seen start without any gloves on. That'll be an aerodynamics decision for sure. And we're back with Tara Whitten.
Looking very composed and comfortable. We should see her go through the timing mat here as the leader.
Very relaxed there. Just coming over the top, this tricky section. You've got to get from the small chainring into the big one. Very, very cautious on this descent.
Tara Whitten is the new leader.
Well, that's one of the most cautious descents that we've taken. This could cost her at the business end when the big guns come out, because it's just such a fine balance on these descents. Evelyn Stevens, time trial specialist.
Big moment, a smile, but intense smile, but nevertheless a smile.
See, all of these riders are carrying radios today. They'll be getting information from the race car about their time checks, about the corners that are coming up. It allows the riders to just relax their focus a little bit, getting the information from the mechanics or the directors or the managers in the car. They'll have one specific person feeding them the information.
Vita Heine, the Norwegian, putting everything into her effort on the time trial. Misha Neodoma and Audrey Cordon. Not the best day, sadly, for the French champion.
Sofiane Duc. We're seeing a replay here of Tara Whitten coming over at fastest time.
So she's well ahead of the Japanese rider, Tara Whitten, and we've got images of her taking that very cautious line down the descent, and perhaps that's where this race will be won and lost today. Here's Emma Pooley.
Well, there was a big question mark about Emma Pooley's form coming into the Olympic Games. She took some time away from the sport and she was selected based on her previous success at big championships, and she managed to hit form this week. It'll be interesting to see how she goes in the time trial. She'll struggle on the descents.
Bronze medalist from 2012, Olga Zabelinskaya, 16th in the road race. Bronze in the road race in London as well.
She's had some recent success too in a race in Germany just a couple of weeks ago, so she's on form.
Late call up to the Olympic Games.
And here we see Kasia Nuadoma, the climbing specialist. She's chosen to lift her visor up. That's an aerodynamic disadvantage, but obviously with the dots from the rain on the visor, she's chosen to lift that up. Rides for Rabo-Liv, the team of Marianne Vos. Big future ahead of her. Not a time trial specialist, but a climbing sensation.
It's now descending that's going to be key to her. She takes a wide line on that first corner. This is Elisa Longoborghini, an Italian.
Well, Lisa will be super focused and motivated by these conditions because she has the best bike handling skills of any of these riders.
And that is what it might come down to in the end.
Well, the thing about time trialing also is that the conditions do change. So you could have better conditions for one rider and worse conditions for another. You can see the cable now of Lisa Brenner's radio. Very focused.
No race radios in the road race, but here in the time trial, critical to get information all the way around the course.
We can see again that she's got a little bottle down the front of her skin suit that she'll reach for later with some fluids. So obviously the Germans have decided that that's a more aerodynamic place to carry a little bit of fluid rather than on the bicycle. Here's Emma Pooley. This is a part of the course that she will like very much, the uphill sections. And she'll be extremely nervous on the descents.
She's been out of the sport at the highest level, although has been competing in triathlons and running, but it's a different matter here. She's come back into it, and we saw in the road race sitting right at the back if she wasn't right on the front. But this is no bunch riding here. But she'd been out and doing the descent that we're coming up to now off this Grimari climb. Will have her very, very nervous indeed.
Absolutely. If there wasn't the technical descents, we would have labelled her more as one of the favourites. But with these conditions and the technical aspect of the descent, she's going to lose a lot of time there. We see, interestingly too, she's chosen a short sleeve skin suit. Most of the riders are opting to cover as much skin as possible. We'll see now how nervous she'll be on this descent.
Tight around that bend, another rider, Emma Pooley, in second place going through that first mark, but 33.16 seconds down on Tara Whitten, the Canadian, who leads the field after 10 kilometres of this women's time trial. We've had no sight yet of the South African, Ashi Moolman-Pasio. She's the one starter we didn't see.
We did have images of her warming up this morning, so that was we haven't had any word that she's ill, or if she's missed the start, that will be devastating, because she was a dark horse for a medal today here in the individual time trial. Certainly one of my favourites to impress people today. She came into the Olympic Games on superb form. She had best condition of her life, and it will be very disappointing. We haven't seen images of her out on the road, so Ashley Moolman-Pasio of South Africa may have missed the start of the Olympic Time Trial Championship. Waiting to get some word on that.
That would be devastating for Ashley. She's meticulous about her preparations and about those sort of things, so it would be absolutely devastating. Now, here is the world champion, Linda Willemsen from New Zealand, our penultimate rider to leave the start ramp.
Well, Linda Willemsen is, in every sense of the word, a time trial specialist, a very specific mentality in cycling, where she enjoys the time trial, she likes to be in control, and you can see it's one of the most relaxed faces we've seen on the start line. This is her thing, she'll be right in her element, and also has tremendous bike handling skills. We haven't seen much of her. She rides for an American team. She chooses not to go up against her competitors during the season. As we said, a very isolated and hidden preparation. But she looks like she's in good form here at the Olympic Games. And definitely a medal chance for today, given these conditions. Elisa Longo-Borghini again.
It looks as though it might be clearing just a little. That or man on the camera bike has cleaned his lens, but certainly conditions still very wet under the bikes. Now they're heading out towards that Grotta Fonda climb, which is 2.13 kilometers. This is Tara Whitten. She was the leader through 10 Ks. Victor has gone through the second marker at 19.7. Kristen Armstrong, two-time Olympic champion, back for an unprecedented attempt at a hat-trick. Away she goes, the last rider out of the start ramp, the American Kristen Armstrong, defending champion, 2008 champion, and a real favorite here for a medal.
Well, she looks very focused and switched on to me, a very powerful start. Little nod of her head on the starting ramp, shows a bit of confidence. Corner comes up very quickly with speed. Another rider choosing not to wear gloves today. But she's wearing the shoe covers, and it's interesting that some riders are choosing the aerodynamic shoe covers and others not. Some recent research has been released that most shoes, like in the case now of Elisa Longo Borghini, without the shoe covers is perhaps faster than any type of material used with a shoe cover. So the Italian Elisa Longo Borghini, already a bronze medal in the road race at the Olympic Games in 2016. Confidence is high, form is good, and the course really, really suits her.
Let's talk a bit about the equipment they're using, the bikes, and how much opportunity they get to prepare on the bikes through the year. And I mean, obviously, time trial is very much part and parcel of the races they ride.
The interesting thing about time trialing is there's so many time trials within tours, but you see a different type of result, because obviously during tours they have different ambitions and they have to work the next day or the previous day, they've had to work for their teammates, so we don't always see the best time trialer win those time trials within tours. But the time trial specialists tend to stay a little bit away from all of those tours and just do a really specific preparation where they can get so used to their bike that that's just not an additional challenge when they line up for an individual time trial. They're so customized to their bike and fitting with it that it's one challenge that they don't have to negotiate. Like here they have such a technical course, they have the weather conditions, so those TT specialists that have spent a lot of time on their time trial bikes, they'll feel a little bit more comfortable today and have less things to contend with. But the equipment today, the changes that they'd have to have made when they got to Rio and saw the course would be the gearing, that they need to have a very small chain ring or a larger, an easier gear than they'd probably usually run in a time trial. Lotte Kopecky, the Belgium rider, young track rider.
And there was a teammate earlier there, Sofian Dijk. Now going through the 19 and a half kilometer marker as we are back with Sofian Dijk here. Victor is the leader. She was first through there. But Yonamin, the Japanese rider, has just gone through there 43 seconds faster than Victor.
We're seeing a very impressive ride from the Japanese today.
Christine Majerus is third fastest through the 19.5k mark. There's the Japanese rider. So 44.49 seconds ahead of Plichter at the moment.
We're back with Elisa Longo Borghini. She's looking to be very relaxed. She's attacking this little sharp pinch. She'll know the course quite well.
Yeah, it's all part of the, been part of the road race, of course, and they've had well, probably some of them 10 days or so in Rio de Janeiro to familiarize themselves with the course, but not in these conditions, it must be reiterated.
Ellen van Dijk, here's one of your favorites as well. Came into the Olympic Games with really good condition. Spent most of the year working for her teammates at Bols Dolmans, but a specific time trial specialist. She has great bike handling skills as well. The short, sharp climbs here will be the challenge for Ellen van Dijk, but as we saw in the road race earlier this week, that she was leading the peloton over the short, sharp climbs. That'll give her a lot of confidence about this circuit as we see her come onto one of the steeper sections.
We've only seen the one rider catch up. There's no question that Audrey Condor was certainly... Here we go, Ashley Moorman-Passio is on the course as she gets over the top now in second place behind Tara Whitten. Well, a sigh of relief, I'm sure, for all the South African supporters because we didn't see Ashley Moorman-Passio start, but she's on the course and going well.
Great news. We didn't get pictures of her at the start. It was a bit of a scary moment that she may have missed it. But as you said, Ashley Moorman-Passio is one of the perfectionists in the sport that does every single thing right. She's a very focused, serious athlete. And all of her energy has been focused into this Olympic Games. And here we see Elisa Longo Borghini coming up to the first time check.
And leading 6.34 seconds faster than Tara Whitten through that mark. So really good start for Elisa Longo Borghini.
And this is where we expect her to take a little bit of time on her rivals on the descent. She has fantastic descending skills, possibly the best of the women's peloton. the wet conditions would have given her a little bit of confidence to take some more time over her rivals on the descent.
Now just watching the descent here, and this is Ellen van Dijk on the steep pitch. They really are these short but very, very sharp climbs. Just to for the Dutch and for our viewers, a lot of you will be wondering how Annemiek van Vleuten is.
Disaster
for Ellen van Dijk. She's gone off the road on this short climb, and that will be so costly for the Dutch time trialist.
Really devastating for Ellen van Dijk, and on the ascent of the climb on the steep section, just a moment of lost focus. This will possibly put her out of contention of the medals. Absolutely devastating.
That is really, really difficult to understand. As Rochelle has suggested, a loss of concentration or focus. She drifted just a little too wide on the... You can see the road there.
Saying it's all about getting that extra little millimeter or, you know, tenth of a second, trying to use every section of the road. That was an absolute disaster for Ellen van Dijk, one of your favorites for today. That would have thrown her mentally. Very hard to refocus now, and on a steep part of the climb getting going, she got a push from the mechanic. She's got to get back into rhythm, but that will be absolutely devastating for her. She did such a great job for her teammates in the road race. Has a chance to have individual glory in the time trial. Head drops now. Very, very hard to start to restart on such a steep part of the climb as well.
The individual time trial champion from 2013 has to dig very, very deep now, as Elisa Longoborghini is the leader on the road at the moment. And she is looking very, very composed and focused on this long drag. It's around 6 kilometers to the base of the Grotta Fonda climb.
Well, you can see that bump in the back of her skin suit. That's the radio that she's carrying to have communication back to her coach, just to give her the time checks, let her know when the corners are coming up and how she's doing. But Armstrong, here's your 2 times Olympic gold medalist in the time trial.
Aggressive looking start from Kristen Armstrong. Had a busy day in the road race. Will the news of what has happened to Ellen van Dijk be conveyed to the other riders?
It will really depend on the manager in the car and knowing his athlete, whether his athlete would want that information. If I was an athlete out there on the road, I think I would like to have that information. Could be a little bit, you know, motivating for those that are in medal contention, knowing that one other rider may have just slipped out of contention.
She's approaching the first timer now, is Ellen van Dijk in the wind, and 19.52 seconds down.
This is the type of motivation that Elisa Longoborghini could do with, because that's going to be very hard for Ellen to pull back. And before that incident, she would have been right up there in medal contention.
Kristen Armstrong, so if you were speaking to, say, Elisa Longoborghini, you would tell her that?
Absolutely. I would just let her know that Ellen van Dijk has had a mishap, and that would be extra motivating for a rider that, you know, might be just thinking at that moment, oh, I've got heavy legs, oh, it's too hard, oh, my power's dropping, you know, so...
I might be fourth or fifth, but I hear that, or I might be third.
Exactly.
Yeah. So Evie Stevens going up the steep climb now.
One of your favourites for a medal today, Evie Stevens, time trial specialist.
6 at the World Championships last year, on 3 stages at the Giro Rosa. Broke the world hour record in February as well. She's had a busy year. Second in the Flèche Wallonne to Anna van der Breggen.
She also had a sensational Giro d'Italia with 3 stage wins and a time trial victory there on a hilly circuit as well. So she's got the results this year on the board.
She beat Anna van der Breggen there, didn't she?
She did.
Yeah. 4 seconds in it.
Anna van der Breggen second in that particular hilly time trial.
Pitch up to that first time he met, and it's Evie Stevens at the moment. It's Elisa Longoborghini who leads after 10, after 19 kilometers. Tara Whitten is leading on the road, ahead of the Japanese rider, you know what I mean?
Oh, Evie Stevens, she's one to struggle a little bit on the descent, so it'll be interesting to see what time check she has over the top, and then how she handles the descent. That's the big question mark for this woman. Can she handle the descent? How much time can she save? Oh, how much time will she lose? Now we're just about to get her first time check.
10th place, 1:05 down.
That's not a good indication for Evelyn Stevens, because it's only going to get more difficult for her from here on in.
Steering clear of the painted line, not crossing over, staying on the right-hand side. Very cautious descender. Yeah, just we were talking when we last saw Ellen van Dijk, who's going absolutely hammering along the flat road here, that Annemiek van Vleuten, who had that horrendous crash in the road race, is all right, well, those who were wondering.
This will give her a little bit of a confidence boost now. That little mishap that Ellen van Dijk had, it can work two ways. When you get back on the bike, you can just, you know, get so much more out of yourself with nerves and heart rates elevated. And now it looks like she's passing a rider out on the road, which will lift her confidence.
Anna Pichter is the first rider home. She started first, and the pole is throwing everything at her to cross the line in 47.5966. The first finisher in the women's individual time trial at Rio 2016. Safely round the course, she set the marker for the time being. Tara Witten out on the course. The most likely contender, as here is the catch coming for Ellen van Dijk.
This just goes to show, without that mishap, that she would have been right up there in medal contention. If she can bring it back to medal contention, that's an impressive ride. But you can see she's digging really, really deep now. To be out there and know that you've been searching for every single hundredth of a second, every single piece of road that you can get, and now having to make that up. She's now taking the dangerous side of the road again, but just putting every single little bit of power into the bike. She didn't want to go around that rider. It would have cost her another 2 seconds. Emma Pooley now, we see, just crosses the line. 57 seconds down on Tara Witten at that time check.
In second place at the moment, Great Britain's Emma Pooley. 57.69, as Michelle said. So Lotte Kopecky heading to the finish. And she will be second fastest as she gets in to the completion of the 29.7 kilometer time trial. Another wonderful experience for a richly talented young rider. We'll see more of her in the future, just 20. She can put the last week down as a two-year university study in terms of her graduation towards being a top-flight professional.
Certainly a rider with a bright future ahead of her. It'll be interesting to see how long she focuses on the track or switches over to the road. We're now looking at Anna van der Breggen, the Olympic gold medalist from the road race in 2016.
Well, she won't be far behind, 1.42 behind. So Anna van der Breggen goes through second fastest through the first of the intermediate timing mats. And this is Olga Zabalinskaya, the bronze medalist from 2012 in both the road and the time trial disciplines. In sixth place through the intermediate point. And now on the flat, having completed the descent, is going to be the Japanese rider. She's ridden through Christine Majerus.
She's had a pretty impressive ride, if you ask me. I think she's come into the Olympic Games with a really, really good condition.
She will be top of the leaderboard. And her time, 46.43.09. Majerus in fourth place, 33 down. It's been an impressive ride by the Japanese rider, under pressure for her place at the Olympic Games. she does it justice. The time being the leader. Zabalinskaya, fourth over the top. 16th in that road race. Father was a gold medalist in the road race in 1980. As Linda Willemsen goes over 13.08. Well, it was expected that it would be a tough course, particularly that first climb for Willemsen. But
you can see here how comfortable she is on the descents. And her and Elisa Longo-Borghini both descend extremely well. And you could see she was just so comfortable dropping down on that descent compared to the other riders that we've seen. So being a little bit behind on that first time check, I think Elisa Longo-Borghini's got a really good climb on her at the moment. Question mark about Linda Willemsen was that she hasn't been racing so much, so we don't really know how her climbing form is. That's how we saw a little bit of her in the Olympic Games road race, but her focus is on the time trial. She's a time trial specialist. The course would go in her favor given that it's wet. On the descents can take a little bit more time, but the big question mark was about her climbing form. Back with Ellen van Dijk, we saw she had a little mishap dropping off the road on the climb just a little bit earlier. Got a bleeding nose for Armstrong. You see a little bit of blood on her shoulder.
She's approaching that first time, and another rider who had to fight for her place in the team, and she is the new leader, Kristen Armstrong, 4.90 as she goes over.
She went out very, very fast from the start, so we've got a race on our hands. Armstrong very focused. The descent's not her forte. She's not bad at descending, but she's not great either, like Willemsen or Longo-Borghini.
She's got that on her skin suit on her shoulder as Ellen van Dijk is absolutely powering along this flat section. This will really suit her. And, well, dare I say it, throwing caution to the wind here because of that mishap she had earlier on the climb. And she is going to leave nothing out there.
As we said, after that kind of mishap, she lost quite a bit of time there. We could probably calculate about 10 to 12 seconds back on the bike and get going again. But sometimes you can make that back with the energy that you get from those nerves.
So Armstrong leading after the first 10-kilometer mark. A lot of Liz Pisto coming through here now. And pushing hard to maybe sneak in front of Victor. Absolutely throwing everything out there. Lotta Lepisto.
Also got the Canadian approaching the finish. It'll be interesting to see how she's held on in the second half of the course. Time trial specialist Tara Witten now looking at Lotta Lepisto. Second at La Course on the Champs-Élysées. A very, very good sprinter. Put in a pretty good time trial here.
Yeah, she's in second at as it stands now, 47.0652.
You know what I mean? Sitting in the hot seat, this is where the riders have to come and sit while they're the fastest time until they're bumped. And this could be the new leader, Tara Witten, coming into the finish.
Tara Witten looking at a place on that on the lounger in the hot seat. She really is powering home here, the Canadian. A track specialist, a time trial specialist, and she is powering over the line and will be the new leader by a big margin, 1 minute 41.93.
Oh, she's set the standard now, Tara Witten. As we said before, she's won championships before Commonwealth Games in 2010. Had a very long career, so experienced with time trialing.
Well, that's an excellent time trial by Tara Witten from Canada. Garford out there, the Australian.
Not having the best of days. Fourth at the World Championships last year. 3 or 4 months ago, you would have put her up there as a medal contender, but all fell apart in the last month with illness.
This is Vita Heine from Norway, It's going to be some way off the time, 5 minutes and 22 seconds of Tara Whitten. Part of the experience for the 31-year-old Team Hitech Products rider. National road racing time trial champion. Cannot be faulted for effort, every one of them. Diana van der Breggen. Road race, can she do what no other woman has done and win both?
Well, actually, for the Dutch, Leon Tin van Morsel in Sydney.
Beg your pardon, yes.
Absolutely. So they the Dutch do have a standard here.
They do, yes.
Leon Tin van Morsel. She won the double road race and time trial. She also took gold in the individual pursuit at the same Olympic Games, 3 gold medals and a silver medal in the points race. So it's a little bit of a standard here for the Dutch that they can, there's a standard, they can win the road race and the time trial double. They've done this before. So Anna van der Breggen, after her victory in the road race, she does come into this time trial as clear favourite. She can descend, she likes the wet, she comes from the Netherlands. Everything about this course says that Anna van der Breggen can be possible winner here today, back with Linda Willemsen, rider we spoke about before, current world champion in the time trial. Question marks over her climbing ability right now. She can descend. She likes the wet weather.
I've got that 2.13 kilometer Grotta Fonda climb to come. Just got the back, the deep section on the front. And here is Audrey Connor. Not been the best day for the French time trial champion. Closing in on the finish.
Certainly haven't seen the best performance that Audrey Cordon's capable of here today. She was sick yesterday. She thought she was sick yesterday, woke up this morning and confirmed she wasn't feeling very well. Had to make that tough decision of, do I ride the Olympic Games road race and show people less than my best? She chose to ride and be out there in front of these amazing crowds.
31 down Audrey Cordon, but she's completed the time trial. Credit to her for committing to it. Here is the final rider on the road, the defending champion, Kristen Armstrong, as fastest through 10 kilometer marker, and is in really, really good form. Also had to fight for her place, two challenges to her position on the American team in the road race.
See Amalusa coming in here from Belarus. She's a fantastic climber. She loves the time trials as well. Time posted of Tara Whitten has been a good one. And then she beat it. She's going to be just a bit off today.
Yeah, minute and 4:57 down for Amalusa. Tara Whitten's time might stay for a while.
We're seeing rather big time gaps so far in this competition.
The conditions are tricky, and some riders relish these type of conditions. Wake up in the morning and it's horrible conditions. They said, I'm on for this. Others back off it.
We talk about the favourites, and Van der Breggen, Ellen Van Dijk, Lisa Longo-Borghini, Linda Willemsen, these are riders that will really thrive on the fact that it's wet and it's even more challenging because they have those skills. You see Anna van der Breggen now moving around a little bit on the bike. Ellen van Dijk, went back with a teammate of van der Breggen on the Dutch team. Dropping her head a little bit. She won't want to do that after what happened earlier. She dropped her head and just veered off the road. Cost her 10 or 15 seconds. She's still in the game.
Absolutely, no question about it. She'll certainly be out there giving absolutely everything. And those riders who are in second place going through the marker, Ellen van Dijk, so despite that mishap, she is second going through 19.7 k's behind Lisa Longo-Borghini.
Well, the fact that the second time check, she was only 17 seconds behind Lisa Longo-Borghini, indicates to me that she would have been on gold medal riding form if she had not have had that mishap.
19 seconds down going through the first marker, so after a really impressive ride as we ride with Lisa Brenner. Now this is Emma Pooley. It's been a tough ride for Emma right from the start. You got the feeling that she wasn't that comfortable. The conditions perhaps not suiting her, but leaving nothing behind as she powers to the finish. Great Princess Emma Pooley, silver medalist in Beijing in 2008. And she hits the line at 1:38.2 seconds down.
Certainly be very disappointed with that ride. She did give it everything, but we saw when she rolled off the ramp at the start of the race, there was so much stress and tension. And as you said, Gerald, it could be due to the wet weather conditions that just threw her a little bit. She's an outside chance of a medal, but not the best day. And Anna van der Breggen looking very, very comfortable.
Well, she'll have taken so much confidence from what was an immensely emotional day on Sunday when she won the gold medal in incredible circumstances. Her teammate Van Vleuten going down in that horrendous crash, and Van der Breggen taking the win.
So just to recap, at the second time check at 19.7 kilometers, the fastest rider so far. Longo Borghini, second through that time check was Van Dijk, and we have approaching Armstrong the second time check. Olga Zablonskaya just crossed the second time check fastest. It's an impressive ride by Zablonskaya.
So the Russian now 6.98 seconds faster than Elisa Longo-Borghini. Yes, Canuel, the second of the Canadians, 1:29.77 down on Tara Whitney, in third place at the moment. So she will take her place on one of the sun loungers, rather ambitious hopes of the sun loungers are today.
It'll be a nice moment for the Canadians to have two sitting up there on the positions until faster riders come in. That's where they'll get comfortable. And this is Linda Willemsen, the Danish-born Kiwi.
Heading up to the slopes of the Rotafonda climb.
She's a rider that's very, very particular about her equipment. It's a challenging aspect of cycling, signing with a professional pro team, but being a time trial specialist and wanting to use all your own specific equipment that you believe in. It's such a mental game. It's very difficult, but Trixie Warwick, Lisa Brenner, sorry.
World champion, of course, in 2013. So in that sense, you touch on the equipment, and it is very specific with the time trial bikes and the time trial specialists. So sometimes issues between pro
teams,
train team and
absolutely. Yeah. It's one of the most difficult things for a time trial rider to negotiate into their contracts, to be able to use specific equipment at big events that they really believe in and that they've tested and that they've had results on. And it's a real difficult mental game. Because, for example, the rider on her screen, Lisa Brenner, she rides for the Canyon Tram team. She may have more belief in a different bike, but this is the bike that her pro team provides her and that she has to ride. So then she has to adapt to that bike. She has to, every year she changes pro teams, and then she has to test it in the wind tunnels, and she has to gain confidence in it.
She's closing in on the top of the climb of the Grottafondo, Lisa Brenner. This marker at the 19.7 kilometer timer, it is Olga Zablonskaya, the bronze medalist in London 2012, who leads by 6.98 from Elisa Longo-Borghini, with Ellen van Dijk in third place, but going really hard. Van Dijk trying to make up time she lost, as Brenner will go through 1:09 seconds down in fifth fastest as she crosses the line down.
That indicates that she's not on top form today. But the impressive ride so far at the second time check from Olga Zablonskaya. We knew she was in good form. You see Lisa Brenner.
Yeah, we talk about those conditions, and as you were explaining, the likes of Van Dijk and Van der Breggen and Willemsen, time trial specialists, but also the mental. Waking up and seeing the rain, and some people will get down about that. Sophie Van Dijk coming through now. And those who feed off that will be, well, they might be feeling down. I'm feeling confident about it. It's not raining, which is good news at the finish here. So hopefully drive all the time as Sophie Ndiak from Belgium comes through in the 11th fastest time.
Yeah, we probably expected a little bit more from the Belgium rider.
Trixie Warwick in sixth fastest, 1:51 down. And Catherine Garfoot from Australia does well and goes second, 33.87 seconds down for Catherine Garfoot. Good second half.
Absolutely. She came home very, very strongly, Australian, to bring back some of that time to be finished in second position at the moment to Tara Whitten.
Fana Bregan is 16 seconds down at the second timer. So in third place at the moment, Anna Fana Bregan.
Oh, she descends well, but 16 seconds of that time check makes it a hard task.
This is a fast, wide descent. But again, caution being shown there by Fana Bregan as Willemsen will be next up there. She's also outside Zabalinskaya's time.
This is a very impressive ride by Olga Zabalinskaya. Like we said earlier, she had that really good result 2 weeks ago at Thuringen, a race in Germany, a very tough race that indicated that she had some fantastic form. We've not seen much of her before that during the season, but an Olympic Games campaigner having already won a medal in the time trial in London 2012.
So it's Tara Whitten at the moment at the finish. But closing in on the finish is the Italian Lisa Longoborghini as Kristen Armstrong challenged for a place by the American time trial champion Carmen Small and Amber Nieben. She had to just keep focusing on what she was going about preparing for the Olympics as that challenge went and the arbitration went around, but she retained her place. And now she's approaching the top of the Grotta Fondo. And at 19.7 kilometer timer.
Looks like she's going to go through.
Longoborghini closing in on the finish. Behind her is South Africa's Ashley Moorman-Passio. But Longoborghini looks as though she might be taking a step onto that podium. Powering into the finish is the Italian. He is going to post the fastest time by 9.22 seconds. And Italy in the hot seat as Ashley Moorman-Passio crosses the line. 1:37.17 down, Ashley Moorman-Passio. For the moment, fifth place for the South African.
Oh, great time posted by Lisa Longoborghini. But the question mark, is it going to be enough against the likes of Zabalinskaya, Armstrong, Van Dijk still in the mix, Anna van der Breggen?
Well, here comes Armstrong at the timer near the summit of the Grotta Fondo climb. And second fastest through there, 2.88 seconds. So she's going to have to dig really deep here over the closing descent and the 8 kilometer flat section through to the finish.
Well, the descent here, you can see a little bit nervous. It's not as technical as the other descent that we saw, so won't lose too much time on this descent. The race we have on our hands through the second time check, we had Olga Zabalinskaya, Armstrong, Longoborghini, waiting to see how Van der Breggen comes through.
And this is Ellen van Dijk moving into top gear as she heads towards the finish. And she will reflect whatever result she gets today. She'll reflect on a moment of concentration loss on the first climb of the Grimari, where she went off the road and into the bushes for a couple of seconds. And a couple of seconds at this level in the time trial at the Olympic Games, absolutely devastating. And she is going to look at that. She's posting a faster time at the moment than Tara Whitten. She's ahead. That is an incredible descent and a last drive to the line here.
She's certainly come home extremely strong. She's been strong all the way through, except for that mishap that she had. She, as we said before, a real gold medal contender without that little mishap that she had. Really interrupted the rhythm on the steepest part of the climb as well. Her teammate from the Netherlands, Anna van der Breggen, out there on the road. Olympic Games gold medalist in the road race.
So So powering is Van der Breggen really in the groove now, looking for a double gold medal celebration for the Netherlands. Linda Willemsen will challenge her. Fifth over the top, Linda Willemsen in the timing. But this is a section that will suit the New Zealand world champion.
She certainly is known to come home strong in time trials as well.
Yes, Van Dijk. Well, she is going to be very close to Lisa Longoborghini's time. 44.5194, the time to beat. She looks up at the finish, head down, and power from Ellen Van Dijk. Former world champion, missed out on a medal by a couple of seconds. Here she goes, she's a leader. A new leader in the hot seat is the Netherlands' Ellen Van Dijk.
It was a very, very impressive ride. We knew she came into this with great form because she was the domestique for a teammate that won the road race. She worked so hard. The question mark was, can she get over those short, sharp climbs? But she led the peloton in the road race over the climbs. She was in fantastic condition, and she's right in the mix now.
Second in the time trial in the World Championships in Richmond last year. Second in the road race and the Olympic road race champion now, Anna van der Breggen. Will know perhaps what has happened up the road that Ellen Van Dijk has posted 44.4874.
Well, this rider had to have come into the time trial as the clear favorite because this course is really well suited towards her. She's a good descender, she likes the wet and the hard conditions. She's climbing as good as anybody at the moment of the time trial specialists. She won the Olympic Games road race.
Ellen Van Dijk made up almost 3 seconds over the last 2 kilometers. Just an incredible drive. She is a powerful rider. This is Kristen Armstrong. So it is getting down to the business end here. Armstrong was second over the top. Zavalinskaya, remember, posted the fastest time. Solovey is Gala Solovey from the Ukraine is making her way to the finish. She'll be well outside the top 10. World Championship silver medalist. She's going to be off, well off the podium here. Solovey will post 48.03353 down. So the focus though on Zavalinskaya, the leader coming over the top of the Grotta Fondo. Lisa Longoborghini, Tara Whitten, and vacant chairs that belongs to Ellen Van Dijk.
Well, Van Dijk will be up there in a moment. Here comes Evelyn Stevens, not such a great ride, but Olga Zavalinskaya behind her. This is going to help Zavalinskaya coming into the finish. She was first at the second time check. Is she going to take the fastest time across the line?
Well, Evelyn Stevens is powering in, but it is Zavalinskaya behind her is the key. She is the leader at the moment. Will she be the leader over the line? Yes, she will, by a significant distance, 16.77 seconds. Zavalinskaya is the new leader of the women's time trial.
Well, that's an impressive ride from Zavalinskaya. As we said before, she's an Olympic Games campaigner. We don't see much of her in those 3 years in the middle, but she certainly hit good form a couple of weeks ago, winning a stage in one of the toughest stage races of women's cycling. Anna van der Breggen. See just in the back of her skin suit there, she's got radio communication. Some riders like it, some riders don't. She's had a pretty untroubled ride so far, very smooth. She's looking good.
She's not far off, is she? Is Anna van der Breggen, the final moments of this time trial, and looking for a glory moment for the Dutch here, Anna van der Breggen.
So there were big time gaps earlier on, but now with all of the gold medal contenders, it's so close. Olga Zavalinskaya, Armstrong, Van der Breggen.
0.05 seconds. Deserted roads here. Not too many braving the weather here. And it'll be Van der Breggen.
This will be a special moment for Van der Breggen if she can win the double, the road race and the time trial. Linda Willemsen, we know she finishes off strong.
This is what suits her, this sort of section of the climb. Really powerful, the route at least. Anuta Willemsen. So she is 20 seconds down at the moment on Zabalinskaya with just under 2Ks to go. 3Ks, beg your pardon. Kristen Armstrong. Well, Armstrong was second going over the top, second to Zabalinskaya. Has she put in time to the Russian over this last sector? Bearing herself here. Lisa Brennauer is closing in on the finish. She will not be on the podium, the German.
Just struggled a little bit with form this part of the season. She's had a fantastic last couple of years.
Giving everything as a former world champion worth 50 seconds. She's in fifth place at the moment, Lisa Brennauer. 39.271 kilometres an hour average over the 29.7 kilometres. Here is Van der Breggen. One little corner.
Is she going to be able to match the time of Zabalinskaya? It's going to be a hard task for her from here.
10 seconds there, 44.3197 is the time of Olga Zabalinskaya, and that won't be beaten. It's not going to be double gold for Anna van der Breggen. It may well be a medal. She's chasing down Ellen van Dijk's time, and Anna van der Breggen is in second place, 5.83 seconds, and just ahead of fellow Dutch rider Ellen van Dijk.
Well, two riders to come in now, Willemsen and the two times Olympic gold individual time trial winner, Armstrong. Will it be a dream? Three gold medals for Armstrong, or will the Russian Olga Zabalinskaya take the 2016 Rio Olympic time trial championship? Linda Willemsen.
Well, Linda Willemsen was she missed out on a medal by a couple of seconds in London. And, she was in fourth place there.
Well, this rider has an extraordinary story in individual time trialing at the World Championships. Five times she was on the podium at the World Championships before she managed to take the gold medal last year. Your current individual world champion on the road now, 20 seconds down from the leader Zabalinskaya. Doesn't look like it's going to be an Olympic gold medal for Willemsen today.
She's got less than a kilometer to go, 20 seconds down, and will that be enough for her to get onto the podium? She's losing a bit of time now, Linda Willemsen. There's Olga Zabalinskaya watching the time all the time, no doubt.
She could be our new Olympic champion. She's delighted to see that Willemsen's not going to bump her off that hot seat. But the only one now is
Kristen Armstrong. Yeah. So Willemsen is slipping away, a medal is slipping away from her. She was fourth in 2012, Linda Willemsen from New Zealand, and she's fourth at the moment. Well, can she drive home? It's not going to be a medal. She'll finish in fifth place for Linda Willemsen, one worse at the moment anyway than in 2012. Brave effort from the Canadian. 22.74 seconds down on the time set by Olga Zabalinskaya. One rider out there, Kristen Armstrong, looking to become an Olympic champion for an unprecedented third time. What tension!
Olga Zabalinskaya is satisfied with knowing she's got that silver medal. Still with Armstrong to come in. Here's your champion from 2008 in Beijing and London 2012. Will she be the new champion? Three Olympic gold medals. This could be history.
The oldest rider in the field, the last rider off the start ramp at Pontol. She's closing in on the finish here. Kristen Armstrong from the United States. Gold in Beijing in 2008. And gold is beckoning here. 4 years after she took the gold, it is going to be Kristen Armstrong, who is the Olympic champion for the third time. An incredible ride by the American. Three times the Olympic champion. She looks back and she cannot believe it.
She's just got news.
She cannot believe it. 2008, 2012, and in Rio in 2016, Kristen Armstrong is the Olympic time trial champion once again. History has been made here. She had to fight for a place. She has certainly vindicated her selection.
We don't know if she has the news yet, but she's in all sorts of pain there on the road. We saw she rode with a bleeding nose, but the experience of winning two Olympic gold medals and now a third here in Rio, it's a dream come true. She's looking at the time as she crosses the finish line.
Well, she retired, then came back to... She's in fact retired twice before, but came back to a challenge for this Olympic medal. Olga Zabolinskaya will be happy with her silver medal. And Anna van der Breggen, well, a bronze medal this time around, but two medals at the Olympic Games. Kristen Armstrong is the Olympic champion. Now it's all starting to come home for the 42-year-old American.
Certainly didn't look like she wanted to celebrate too early, waiting for that news. But this is a dream come true. Just phenomenal experience with preparing for a Olympic Games gold medalist in 2008, gold medalist in 2012, and now the gold medalist here in Rio in 2016. She can't believe it. Now it's starting to sink in.
Absolutely. Emotion for the 42-year-old. Confirmation that Kristen Armstrong is the 2016 Olympic time trial champion ahead of Olga Zabolinskaya and the Netherlands' Anna van der Breggen as we roll down through the finishes. Evelyn Stevens in 10th place. Ashley Mormont-Passio finishing in 12th. Emma Pooley of Great Britain in 14th. All the way down to Vita Heiner, the last of the finishers. Audrey Cordor, tough day for their French champion. Not well today. Well, a third gold medal for Kristen Armstrong. Three hip replacement surgeries since her last gold medal. Third at the US Champs last year. She didn't win the title this year. Carmen Small won that. She had to fight off a challenge for a place in the team from her and from Amber Nieben. This was a critical moment in the day.
Ellen van Dijk, you see there, if she hadn't have done that, she would have been in the mix for the medals. So close, so disappointed.
That's the other side of the emotional roller coaster. Yep, three gold medals, can you believe it? Returned from a retirement in 2015.
Be fantastic for the USA, having a little bit of a disappointing road race. The question mark over whether Armstrong should deserve a position in the team, having had time away from the sport, but experience says everything.
That was one of the reasons she retired initially, and to have a family. And what a delight, what a wonderful moment. Amazing performance by, trained specifically for this, focused on this only. And it does show it's such a specialist discipline, this.
Absolutely, and experience goes a long way. We didn't know she would handle the wet descents, but she did extremely well. Just that experience of knowing how to pace yourself in a time trial. Olga Zabolinskaya absolutely delighted with the silver medal. Bronze medal at London 2012 in the individual time trial. Proven again, an Olympic campaigner.
Oh, wonderful family time for Armstrong. Will she be back? Well, she didn't want to use the term retirement, but she says she's going to plan on focusing on a full-time job. She's director of community health towards at Duke's Hospital in Idaho. So,
also very involved in her professional team that she owns. 2016, a program that develops riders for the Olympic Games. A mentor for many athletes. So much experience, so much confidence in her ability to prepare specifically. Like any time trialist, doesn't leave any stone unturned in preparation.
Or out on the route, you can see she's absolutely spent as she should be. A huge effort by Kristen Armstrong.
42 years of age, three Olympic gold medals.
Well, Ellen van Dijk, so much hope at this stage of the ride. It all came apart for the Dutch rider on on the climb up Grumari. A loss of concentration. Zavalinskaya. Bronze in London, silver in Rio. Armstrong, gold in Beijing, gold in London, gold in Rio.
She looks so relaxed out there. You can see that she's just completely in control, very aware of what's going around her as well. You can see there she's looking around, unlike other athletes that are completely in the zone. She's having a chat there, the gold medalist and the silver medalist of today's time trial.
Medalha de bronze, representando os Países Baixos, Anna van der Breggen.
All smiles now for Anna van der Breggen. Disappointment in not making it a double gold, but bronze after a road race gold. She is the acknowledged young star of the road scene at the moment on the women's tour.
Médaille d'argent, représentant la Fédération de Russie.
Silver medalist, representing the Russian Federation.
Medalha de prata, representando a Federação da Rússia, Olga Zabelinskaya.
Bronze medalist on the road race and the time trial in London 4 years ago, silver medalist in Rio in 2016.
Médaille d'or, championne olympique, représentant les États-Unis d'Amérique.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion representing the United States of America.
Medalha de ouro e campeã olímpica representando os Estados Unidos da América, Kristin Armstrong.
In the rain, Kristin Armstrong steps up to collect a third time trial gold medal in the Olympic Games, three in a row. Remarkable. Beijing, London, and now Rio. Phenomenal performance by the 42-year-old. Keeping her emotions in check. Family timeout for Armstrong. She had to fight for a place in the team, and she's vindicated that in the best possible manner.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne des États-Unis d'Amérique.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the United States of America.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino dos Estados Unidos da América.
A slice of history for Kristin Armstrong, a third consecutive Olympic gold medal in the individual time trial.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, as medalhistas olímpicas.
Silver for Olga Zeblinskaya and Anna van der Breggen in the bronze. So the medalists in the women's individual time trial, Kristen Armstrong from the United States, Olga Zeblinskaya from Russia, and the Netherlands, Anna van der Breggen.